Hello everyone, just the lady, this is one more. Welcome back to my channel and let's continue to know more about Herbert's Tibet trip. And on the morning of their fourth day in Tibet, Herbert and his group visited the Tangka Art Academy, a training base for Tangka artists. The academy also displays on the whole process of making a tanka from the earliest steps of choosing, fixing, gluing, polishing, and strengthening a canvas to the design and coloring of the finished work. Tanka, you know, like the one unfolded at the Drupa Monastery, are also the uniquely Tibetan kind of religious painting. While there, Herbert took the opportunity to try his hand at painting a simple tanka by himself. In the afternoon, they all went to the banks of the Lhasa River for a local style picnic, unfolding the blanket and spreading it on the ground. There were a huge variety of local snake food, including yak jerky, beer, and sweet tea. Like any picnic, people sat down eating and chatting. After a while, some Tibetans got up and began dancing a local circle dance, which eventually taught to Herbert and his fellow tourists. Leaving Lhasa on their fifth day in Tibet, the group traveled the Qinghai-Tibet Highway to Lake Namtso. Along the important road for trade and traffic in the northern Tibet, there were all kinds of scenery to be seen, including rows of Tibetan houses and herdsmen on horses. During one stop, Herbert got into a discussion with a herdsman named Jasang. Jasang and his family made their living from grazing cattle and sheep. And prior to building a modern house with the government subsidies, they had lived a traditional Tibetan backyard. Now, their settlement not only afforded them easy access to health care, it also provided Jasang's children with convenient schooling. Lake Namtso, with 4,780 meters above sea level, is one Tibet's three sacred lakes. During the 5-hour drive there, Herbert and the rest of his tour group enjoyed themselves looking out the windows at the stunning grassland scenery of the North Tibet. Namtso first came into the view as they crossed the Lakhin La Pass. At the lakeside, they rode the white yaks around and sometimes met the older devoted women who come here to walk around the 1,920 square kilometers lake and pray. Their sixth day in Tibet saw them travel to Ningxi Prefecture by a newly opened rail line, a part of the Lhasa-Chengdu line. This 403 kilometers long spur has a design speed of 160 kilometers per hour. This is relatively slow compared to other high-speed rail lines in China. But as Herbert's guide explained to them, that rail construction was really much harder than other provinces, and it just wasn't practical and possible to build a railway with 300 kilometers per hour design speed. Not long after a train trip began, the Yarlodambo River came into view, flanked by rows of trees either atop dunes or in the marshy wetland to either side of the water. Their guide explained that these trees had been planted to prevent sandstorm. The whole area north of the river was facing the desertification, and prior to the tree planting campaign, sand picked up by the wind was regularly spread throughout the villages along the river banks. Now, however, artificial forest covering thousands of hectares decorated the land like man-made blanket of green. About an hour or so after they got on board, they disembarked at the Jana Station in Toka Prefecture. From here, they took a coach to the famous Samye Monastery. Along the way, Herbert noticed a group of children practicing some kind of dance on their school playground. In answer to his questions, the guide explained that these pupils were doing exercises adapted from a local traditional circle dance. In this way, the kids not only can get in their physical activity, they also got to keep in touch with their traditional culture. So I used to be the same at school. I also need to dance, so miss. Once their visit to the monastery was over, they returned to the train and continued onward to Ningxi. This would be their last night in Lhasa. For dinner, the guide took them to the Lulang International Travel Town, a decade-long investment project with assistance from Guangdong Province. Lulang provided Herbert and the rest of the group with a beautiful night view, local stone pot stew chicken, and German beer. After there is a chance, I also want to make an appointment with my friends to go there and then I can share with you. Come morning of the 7th day, it is time to depart Tibet via Ningxi Airport in Meilin County. On their way to the airport, they stopped at an orchard in the Yarlo Dzangbo River Valley, 2,900 meters above sea level, with apple trees outside, strawberries and grapes in their greenhouses. It was a good example of how modern agriculture practices have been changing in the region. Testing some strawberries and buying some grapes to take with him, Herbert bade farewell to the guide and thanked him for a wonderful trip. From the above, we can know that the Herbert's trip in Tibet was really interesting, right? So at present, Lhasa, Tibet also cannot go out. Otherwise, I can go out to shoot more interesting places in Tibet and bringing you experience together. I think the days that we can go out should become fast. And if you have the opportunity, sincerely welcome you to have a look in Tibet. And it's time to say goodbye to everyone. See you next time. Bye. Desu de le.